I am about to be kid free.
And it has the pockets. Mama on my hood, I look fly, I look good.
We have officially made it to the weekend. It is Saturday and I am about to be kid free. My mom is picking up Zuri for the weekend. She won't be back till next week. So that means more time with my man, my man, my man. So we're getting ready to hit the road. Yes, we're getting ready to go and she's ready. So I think we're just gonna probably do dinner or brunch today. And just chill out because we are hosting an event at our house tomorrow. A lot of fun planned this weekend and just relaxing and catching up on work. I flexi rod my hair and I love how my curls came out. And I want to make best use of the weather this weekend because it is in the low 70s. So it feels pretty good. So I am going to have Rudy take a million photos of me this weekend. I got a lot of cute outfits that I just want to put on, take photos, do some videos and all that stuff. So while Zuri is gone, I am going to maximize my time and try to get as much content done in between all the other stuff we have to do.
I totally forgot to record while I have been out. Like, I literally been running and ripping and running and running all over the place. So where are we at? Today is Sunday. I just got back home from church. I'm gonna have to say my husband is doing an amazing job with taking my photos lately. I mean, look at them, just bomb. So we have been doing a lot of that, taking pictures over the weekend. We went to an Italian festival last night, which was really fun, but it was really dark and I did not want to be out with my bright light just trying to film just because, so I didn't film. But it's Sunday. It is getting ready to be the start of a new week. We're actually hosting our close friend's anniversary dinner in our backyard today. So I've been just cleaning the house, getting everything ready. It's just really nice to be able to have a home that our family and friends feel safe enough to want to, you know, throw celebratory events at. And I'm also happy that we actually have loads of tables and chairs and so much decor that we've had left over from when we had our wedding in our backyard for our family and friends to be able to use when they need it. So yeah, today we are having a nice little get together. She's inviting family and friends to our home and cooking and all that good stuff. The weather's not too bad. It's a little bit of, you can't really see, but it's a bit of an overcast. It said it's not supposed to rain, so we'll see. But yeah, this weekend has been crazy fun. Zuri is having the time of her life at her Mimi's, and Rudy and I just really, we've just been laying around and just going out when we can. We went to this really nice restaurant yesterday, grabbed some really good food, and I think that's just gonna be our thing, just finding new restaurants to try and just really enjoying our time together when Zuri's not here. And I did a lot of shopping today at Old Navy for Zuri right after church because I had some super cash saved. I'm so shocked at the fact that I have never really given Old Navy the time of day like I do now years ago, because the clothes are cute and it's at a reasonable price. I mean, this dress I have on, I got from Old Navy on clearance. I mean, just super cute. I'm gonna show y'all the stuff that I got Zuri. I spent less than $150 for everything. And you know, with the fall season being amongst us, everything is like a little pricey. But I got really good deal on this stuff. How cute are these Chelsea boots? Oh, super cute. Cream. I gotta get her into neutrals because she has a ton of pinks. I got her colors that I personally like to wear. I got her this really cute black bomber jacket. And I got her this really cute khaki jacket, and I got the same one in green. I went ahead and decided to go up a little bit in size because she's a 2T, but sometimes she'd be fitting a 3T, and I just wanted to be on the safe side to make sure I get clothes that she can actually grow into. I got this really cute cream cardigan, and it has the pockets, and I have one looking, I have one that looks just like this, so we're gonna match. And I got her these black and brown Chelsea boots. Just come on, she is about to be super fly. Then I got Rudy this Selena shirt that he has been begging to get. We went, one of our close friends, he has a vintage store, and he had this Selena shirt that he was not trying to sell. And Rudy has been wanting a Selena shirt so bad. So when I saw this on sale, I had to grab it. And then I had grabbed him some jeans. Ladies, get your man some jeans from Old Navy because they're good quality. They're nice and thick. And they're reasonably priced. And I shop there so much, so they send me coupons, the Super Cash. So it has just been, it has just been my go-to place. So a lot of the looks that y'all gonna be seeing on Instagram, here on YouTube, more than likely I got it from Old Navy. And I'm just an Old Navy girl now. Like, it just is what it is. But looking out the window, looks like my girl Kiara is here, so the party is about to get started. So I'm gonna try to film as much as I can because I know I'm about to just be ripping and running all over the house. But yeah, I wanted to make sure I actually got on here to close out my vlog because I'd be forgetting to do that because I just be so caught up in the motion of just filming. So yeah, filming and living life pretty much. So yeah, let's get this party started. Ooh, is that my song? And we got the R&B going because they're celebrating their 1 year anniversary. It's Monday, y'all. I literally just got out of the bed. I was up making music. I didn't go to bed till almost 6 a.m. But we got the job done. We submitted the music. So I came over here to Lowe's so I can pick up some compost because I am getting ready to build out my garden in my backyard for the fall. And I need to return that Il Maquillage foundation to the post office and mail it back. I don't think I'm gonna actually buy another one. I'm just gonna return it because my Fenty has been doing me well. And since they got the wrong shade this time, I don't wanna go through trying another one again. So I'm here at Lowe's getting ready to pick up the stuff that I ordered for the garden, take this package back to the post office. And I think I'm just gonna pick up some food for lunch or take my husband out for dinner today. Zuri is still at my mom's and I'll pick her up tomorrow. So I'm trying to get in some little date night in with the hubby before she comes back. So yeah, this is a pretty chill Monday. I just started my Mom Fit series, which I'm really excited about. And I've gotten really good feedback about just showing my fashion style changing over time and just being a mom and just trying to figure out how to dress this new body. And I need to actually go home
after I finish running my errands and try to shoot as much content as I can, because I did film a YouTube vlog for my Temu haul, but I actually want to put on each and every outfit to make content for TikTok and Instagram and Pinterest. So that's what I'm going to try to accomplish today. And I actually need to figure out where exactly I'm going to shoot, because my office is beautiful, but there's not any natural light coming directly in the room. So I have to make light with all the lights that I have plugged in. But I'm thinking about shooting all of these mom fit of the day in my living room, since there's a direct window in the living room. I'll just have to move my couch every single day. So I'm thinking that's just what I'm going to have to do. And I'm just going to have to suck it up until things change. Oh no. My sister just texted me. She said Boosie got diabetes. It's a video of Boosie cooking, and he's using a bunch of, what is he making? Please tell me this ain't spaghetti. Shout out to the sisters, because, you know, as much as I don't talk to my sisters every day, we are constantly sending memes to each other back and forth every single day. Like, that's just how we communicate. And if you got a sister, let me know if y'all doing the same thing, because I'd be like, dang, we might address some real life stuff here and there, but we too busy trying to laugh, because life be lifing. I want some chicken. I really do. And I'm debating if I want to go to OTR to go to, I think it's called Karen G, or if I want to go to Rooster's. Because either one of them, they got some fire Korean barbecue wings. And that's what I'm craving right now. Oh, y'all. I just ordered the Nama Well juicer. Finally. I told Rudy that I wanted it for Christmas, but I couldn't wait. Like, I needed it now. I've been using my sister-in-law's juicer, and I noticed it's not like a slow pressing juicer. So when all of the, I guess, what do you call it? The pulp and the excess fruit comes out of the opposite end, there's still so much juice left. And my girl Imani, she has been juicing, which I just got her book. It has a lot of like beautiful and good juicing recipes, and I've already started using it. But she has the Nama Well juicer, and I was like, ooh, that looks like a really good juicer, because you could make sorbet, milk, all types of stuff with the juicer. I looked that thing up. That juicer is almost $600. And I was like, you know, I ain't about to spend $600 on a juicer. So I tried to find like dupes of it, but I'm so thorough when it comes to reviews. I was like, oh no, I can't. I just went ahead and just got it. I just bought it. And I think my total came out to like almost $670. Because I got the other accessories to make sorbet and remove the pulp. And at first I was really trying to convince Rudy like why I needed to spend $600 on a juicer, but I explained to him that when we're juicing using our current juicer, there is so much juice that is left behind because it's just not pressing it all the way out. And I want to be able to make our own fresh ice cream so we can stop buying ice creams. I want to be able to make Zuri fresh milk from scratch. And if we're really going to embark this journey of eating healthier and providing nutritious meals for our family, I need to invest in myself. I've already started going to the Finley Market, getting fresh meats, fresh fruits, and getting local homegrown produce. So me getting this Nama Well juicer is just another step closer to me getting my goals. Plus, since it's such a great juicer, I know I'm going to be using it all the time. And A couple weeks ago, I did a water fast, and I absolutely loved the way it made me feel. I did a water fast for 5 days straight. No food, just simply water. And I got so close to God, and, you know, it was rough the first couple of days, but over the course of the 5 days, my mind was just clear and everything like that. And we do juice fastings, but I want to do it for longer periods of time because I truly see the benefits in doing it. So me getting this Nama Well juicer is just proving the point of why I needed it in the first place. It's an investment. I need it. Just simple as that. So I can't wait to show y'all the juicer. It said it'll be here on the 14th. So I cannot wait to get it. I already got the old one boxed up, ready to go in the trash. Cause I'm like, I can't wait to go to the grocery and like actually get some more stuff and actually juice with it. And of course I'm going to film it. So yeah, I'm really, really, really excited. Cause I've been wanting this juicer for almost a year now. And I was like, I don't know if I could spend that much on a juicer. I don't think I can. But like I said, I'm at this point now where I just have to invest in my health and do what I need to do. And it comes with a really great warranty. And I strongly believe it's going to last me for a long time. And a lot of the fitness gurus that I follow that are, you know, very dominant in the juicing space, that's what they use. So if I got to get the best, I'm going to get the best. And this just is what it is. So I can't wait. Oh, I need to go to the post office so I could drop these packages off and call it a day. Made it to the post office, about to return. Some stuff I got from Express, doing their style trial, and this little maquillage foundation that did not work. So I just ordered my food and I'm picking that right up. It's so sunny today. I just realized I have not filmed at all today, but it is Tuesday. My dog is peeking in the back. It's been pretty chill. Went to go pick up Zuri. She's a little irritated right now, and I literally just put her down for a nap. She hasn't had one all day, and it's almost 5 o'clock, or it's past 5 o'clock now, and she's just now taking her first nap of the day. So I did get some content done. I have been really consistent with this mom fit of the day, which I'm really excited about. So getting myself together, doing all my hair, putting on nice clothes, and just going about my business has been very effective for me. So now, since I have some downtime, I'm going to finish watching Suits with my husband and edit some vlogs that I have not been editing because I have been so occupied with all the million other things that I've had to do. So it is just going to be an editing type of day today.
It is Wednesday and we are flying through the week. I'm getting ready to go to the gym. Zuri's back. Say hi, Zuri. Hi, Zuri. She said hi, Zuri.
So I'm really excited because I just got a notification that my juicer is going to be here this afternoon. So after I hit the gym, I need to go to the farmer's market, get some produce so I can juice, and then work on some content. I was really happy today because Zuri got some really cute clothes from Old Navy, and she's older now and she's really starting to like being in front of the camera, and she knows when I pull out the camera that it's time to shoot. So I got some really good content with her and all her fall outfits and stuff. And what else is going on today? Not too much. You know, I had a conversation with some really big content creators yesterday, just asking them for advice because I've been following their journey for many years. And, you know, not once have I felt intimidated or jealous that they surpassed me when it comes to like following, because I know that everything will happen for me in God's timing. And I think the important thing to do is when you see people in your industry getting their accolades and their wins is to congratulate them and not feel some type of way because you started before them. You're not seeing progress. Like, blah, 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 all that stuff. So I've just been reaching out to big content creators that are in the fashion space and just really humbling myself and asking for advice, because I know that I am a nano influencer coach and I'm teaching content creators how to monetize their content, but I don't know everything. And since I am now creating fashion content, what better way to ask for advice is to go to the ones that are like killing it in the space. And I have to say that the women that I have reached out to, they have been so real and genuine with giving me the inside scoop on what's going on, what type of pay partnerships they're getting, and just giving me actionable advice to be able to implement within my own content strategy. And I had a really good conversation with the creator, and I'm just so, so, so thankful that she gave me so many good gems for me to try out. And I'm just excited for what's to come with me now introducing fashion into my content. You know, when I think about how I was in my younger years, I was always keeping up with the trends, especially when it came to like urban streetwear. You know, I was in the Coogi, the House of Darion, I can't even think of all the brands. Like, I worked inside a store called Jimmy Jazz, and we had all the latest streetwear. So because I worked there, I was always laced up. I mean, the newest clothes, newest J's, Forces, all that stuff. And not that I want to revert back to that style, but I knew how to get my fits off. And I think that since I've been a mom and so much has changed with my body, figuring out what type of clothes fit me and look good on me, I'm still trying to navigate on what's going to work for me. But the creator I was speaking with yesterday, she was just really telling me like, hey, do what's comfortable for you, do what's practical, and just know that just because you're stepping into the high fashion space, it doesn't mean that you need to be given New York Fashion Week every week, because it's not realistic. Now, the girls that put it on, they put it on, but I'm a mom and my content is for other moms. And as much as I want to dress and wear heels every day, I'm not about to be wearing heels in the house. So when I'm doing these mom fits of the day and doing these new fashion series, I just really want to create real practical outfits that I love to wear and that will hopefully inspire other moms to want to dress up day to day. Because being a stay-at-home mom, child, it was either sweatpants or gym clothes. Like, that's it. And, you know, I'm just at this space where I just need to do better. You know, she's getting older. She's paying attention to what I'm doing. Like, she's putting on lip gloss because she sees me putting on lip gloss. She knows what to do with the brush and the curling iron because she sees me using it. And she knows how to put her clothes on. And she's only two. So she's watching me. And I don't want to be looking like a bum all the time. And her to have this memory like, dang, mama never got dressed when I was growing up, so I don't need to do the same. I don't want to do that. Like, I need to be dressed up so she could see her mom just getting it. So yeah, we're getting ready to go to the gym. I know I just said a mouthful, but I still got that manure in my trunk. It doesn't smell, but I just realized I have not gotten it out the trunk yet, and I need to do that today. Farmer's market after the gym, get some produce. I'm actually going to pick up some seeds that I want to start planting in our garden, and then just work on some content. I have some really good real life conversation topics that I want to start recording, which I'll probably do that after the gym. And yeah, we're just going to run a little bit errands, take it easy, and unbox my new juicer. I cannot wait, y'all. Like, my husband woke up, he was like, your juicer comes today, don't it? I said, yes, it does. Yes, it does. He's even paying attention because I know he's excited to see it. I know he is. But yeah, this is like real adulting. Adulting is when you are excited about home appliances. Like, this is it. Sorry, let's get this day rolling. Out of the grave, yeah. Out of the grave, yeah. I'm on the way, yeah. Out of the grave. Serving the father of time, and that's whether I got on a paddock or not. Canada goose for the cold, and they told me to count on my blessings. I counted a lot. Almost like, tell me, is you down? Cause I'm trying to go gold tonight. Hoes and hoochies dead to right. I just wanna live in a fantasy. Made a pit stop to Walmart, and I'm gonna see what I can find that is fall related. Say hi. Wanna say hi? No? Wanna say hi?
Hi.
They have completely rearranged the one by my house, but I do see some items in the Sophia Figuera section. I'm gonna show y'all. I'm really liking these brown jeans. They're not like leather, but it's kind of like a pleather feel to it. So I'm gonna see if they got my size. You like those? Yeah? It's the market. The sun's popping out now. I am really just coming in here to get some produce and call it a day because I just got the alert that my juicer just got in the mail. So let's get to shopping.
Are you vlogging? Or
yes, I'm vlogging.
Yes.
Fine, thank you, Sid.
Thank you. I don't want to get shy. Thank you so much.
No problem. The market had absolutely no produce. So I'm thinking I might go to Aldi's to get my fruit. I like their fruit better than I like Kroger and Walmart. I really wanted to get a watermelon with seeds, but everything they have is seedless. So, might have to pause on the watermelon for right now. But, yeah, I did get some really good looking ceviche. I love ceviche. A girlfriend of mine, Dahlia, she made it one day at a fight night party, and it was my first time I ever had it. And I mean, it was authentic, like made from scratch. It tasted fresh. It was so good. And ever since then, I'm like, I could literally eat this every day. I'm about to get some food so I can go back home. I need to get this sweat off me. It is here. Ending this week's vlog at Kings Island. It is a family day. It's actually Zuri's first time at an amusement park, so I'm really excited. And I haven't been on a roller coaster in a very long time, so I'm excited for myself. Rudy won't be riding no rides, but I will. I probably will only be the only one riding rides, but it's gonna be fun. It feels really good today. It's 77, so the weather is just perfect. You ready? You've never been here before. Your beads came off? Oh, how? Man.
hotel you wanted?
The Mega.
I think I heard the Mega.
Yeah. Mega. The Elephant.
Elephant. Do you want an Elephant?
Oh, look, Zuri. You get the Elephant.
Thank you.